So today, what are your best resources to help you stay motivated and committed to your goals? Let's get into it. Well, the band was hopping and the crowd was bopping at the joint on a Friday night. When this dude saunters up and tells me, he said, "Son, you're doing all right, but you know, I could show you a thing or two, how you could play better still. I got 10 guitars, they're all signed by stars, so you know I got plenty of skill. I'll show you how to play real loud, that's how you really get the crowd, don't you know? Who I think I am." Hey everybody, I'm Dan DeWyron. Welcome to Live Center Stage, your channel for discovering that it's never too late to live your passion. You know, I wrote that verse one night after being told by a dude that I didn't play loud enough, and you know, he could show me how it's done. But the musician volume is, that's one of my pet peeves, but that's a story for another video. You know, I do spend a lot of time hanging out with musicians, and many of them who are my age, you know, want to talk about how being a musician these days just kind of sucks. You know, in the good old days, there was, you know, more money, there were more places to play, and the audiences were bigger. And I know I might be ruffling a few feathers here, but the conversations, you know, can be very negative at times, because I feel extremely privileged and fortunate to be, you know, playing music for a living. And for sure, things have changed, but, you know, everybody's job has changed in the last few decades. But I noticed something that would happen in these conversations. After, you know, chatting for about 10 minutes or so, I'd find myself agreeing and going, you know, yeah, the good old days. And I start feeling, you know, a little bit depressed and my attitude becoming negative, and even wondering if this passion of mine was just an illusion and how this sucks. And whoa, you know, has this ever happened to you? Because I'm pretty sure these bitching sessions are common regardless of what profession you're in, you know. Which brings me to the topic of today. What are your best resources to stay positive, motivated, and committed to your health and fitness and your center stage goals? And, you know, not being influenced by all that negativity. Well, I say it's the people that you surround yourself with. If you're around negative people, you'll be negative. If you're around people who have no dreams, ambitions, and goals, you'll push your dreams to the background. And if you're around people who don't believe in you, you'll doubt yourself and you'll give up on yourself and settle. So on the other hand, if you're around people who encourage and support you, you get a whole blast of energy, you know, and confidence. If you're around people who are committed to learning and growing, you'll feel empowered to grow and you'll learn from them. And that's the key. You know, for me, this meant even limiting some of the time with, you know, some of my friends. I mean, we're still friends, but I recognize that they can sometimes really drag me down, and I can't afford to take that chance. And I also find that some people, you know, can put you down when you are on that path to living your passion, because it kind of makes them feel bad about themselves if they're not, you know? So putting you down makes them feel better. So you gotta find positive people with similar interests, passion, and goals. It's a real game changer. You know, maybe it's joining a club in the field of your passion, or finding a mentor is also a huge benefit. I've come to realize that positive people with experience, like, they're usually generous about sharing that experience, and that's helping me out tremendously on this journey. I also realize that many mentors find that, you know, giving back and sharing their experience is very fulfilling. And their generosity encourages others to do the same for others, you know? This inspires me, actually, to look to the future and hope to be in a place where I can pay their generosity forward. So, and sometimes, you know, you just have to cold call and reach out to maybe find someone that might be a good fit. You never know until you do that reaching out. You might find a great mentor. So surround yourself with positive people. Pay it forward. Find a mentor. Soak up their experience and advice and become a mentor to others. Be that positive voice in the room, you know. Join a club or group to support yourself and support others. And reach out to other people in your field of interest who have similar goals. You gotta nurture these relationships and understand that they're your best resources. So how do you stay positive and focused on your goals with all the negativity that's out there? Let me know in the comments below, and don't forget to click the subscribe button and the notification bell so you'll always know when new videos come out. Oh, by the way, if you want to hear the full album version of Don't You Know Who I Think I Am, I'll leave a link in the description below where you can download a free copy. That dude from the first verse makes another appearance in the two bridges of that song. I'm pretty sure most of my musician friends have met many characters like him, for sure. You probably have in your job as well, people who know better, you know. My grandmother, she had 14 kids. She worked incredibly hard, and when people spoke about the good old days, she'd say, you know what? They can have the good old days. I agree with Mama. You can't change the past, but don't limit your future. This is your center stage. Go out there, give the performance of your lifetime, and I'll see you in the next video. Go ahead and make that call. We'll see who takes the fall. Don't you know who I think I am?